The question today is Obi dying in Loki season 2?
Okay, well, that's an interesting question because my question was going to be, is Victor Timely going to kill Obi by the end of the season?
I love it when things like this happen. You know, this is destiny, this is fate, this is the TVA at work right now.
Something fishy is going on, and I do think the odds of Obi dying just went through the roof, actually, by Victor Timely actually ending up at the TVA. But before we get into anything else, we have to do fact of the day. Page number 189, fact number
4.
The word pencil comes from a Latin word meaning small penis.
Sounds about right.
It depends on the size of the pencil. And to be fair, it's about what you can do with the pencil, not about just the size or girth of it.
Right, right, correct, right. Correct.
The lead is the most important thing.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Laying the pipe down. That's what it is, right?
Yeah.
Okie dokie. Hey, Narendra the Comic Man.
Nonsense.
Yes, and right now we're going to be doing a quick review of Loki Season 2, Episode 3, which, while not being the best of the three episodes so far, actually may have been better than the second one.
Yeah.
Indicating the first one was the best one.
Yeah, first one was the best, mm-hmm. Then it's the third episode, the second one's lagging behind. Mm-hmm. But I look at that saying, hey, we're technically now on an upwards trajectory.
Right, back on the up and up.
Right, I will say the actual standard of season two generally is significantly higher than season one. Yeah. We are actually able to throw ourselves into this story, into these characters, and to some extent we are enjoying the theorizing as we're watching. We're really getting into it, and not everything's super obvious as it did feel like with season one.
Yeah, season one felt like I was looking through plain looking glass.
Yeah.
Not even stained glass. It was just, oh, you're doing that? Of course you're doing that. Why would you do anything else? But why did you do that?
Yeah, I will say now it's more like we're looking through mirrors. We see the options, but we're not sure of the route the writers are going to take to get to that destination.
That's a valid point.
And that's where the spice is laying with this story. I will say, I was pleased to see some character growth from someone called Sylvie. This isn't a satirical clap. I am genuinely happy. I really was so pleased to see that inflective moment within Sylvie, mm-hmm. understanding, wait, this isn't who I want to be. I've become the thing I hated the most, a TVA just independently working mm-hmm. as a single agent. And she actually did let Victor Timely go. And then she also let Ravonna go as well.
Yeah, which she let Renslayer survive,
yeah.
Which was very surprising. But at the end of the day, it does show the development of a character not letting that hold power over her in the idea of killing them, which she was kind of beholding her past, present, and future to. And by doing what she's done, I do feel like she may have wiped her internal slate clean.
Yeah, I feel like the guilt is now going to start to wear off, and now she's actually going to be able to move on with her life because she's moved past this point.
Right.
Which I'll be happy to see if she moves on with her life in an adjacent story that we never have to see again.
Yes, yes, because I do think there is a good chance she might be right about Victor Timely, even though she let him go in the end. I think there's something a bit off about him. Not just because he was acted very weirdly by Jonathan Majors. It was a bit skittish. It was a bit, oh, I don't know what I'm doing. I'm a bit of an insane kooky scientist, but I'm just a con man at the end of the day, which was very, very out there. But I think you saw his own motivation very clearly, and that was he wants power, and he wants it on his own.
Yeah.
And I think him going to the TVA is going to show him, I don't have all the power, but I need it. And Obi is that threat, which we said in episode one, we said, nah, this guy has too much knowledge. He has too much information. He is too much of a loose cannon.
100%. I really do see Victor Timely coming into the TVA, understanding that he was actually small fry and thinking to himself, well, everything that Sylvie in this Loki said within that carriage about me being dangerous, me being powerful, me being this big bad, I guess that's on the books for me. I guess I could become that, and now I'm here. This is the perfect place for me to really gain my potential, meet that.
In his mind, the only way he can achieve that is by taking out the person who gave him the inspiration to become He Who Remains, or Kang, which is Ouroboros.
Yeah, and he did call Ouroboros his, like, inspiration when he was talking about going through the handbook. I want to meet this guy, you know, this guy gave me everything. I'm so, so sure. I couldn't be any more sure. He is absolutely going to slaughter him, and Obi isn't going to see it coming.
And he doesn't need it. I like that character. He's got this zip, this zest for life about him, and you need a bit of that. But I think he's getting got. One of the things I actually didn't like about this episode was this weird love triangle between Renslayer, Kang, and Miss Minutes. We don't want Ultron 2.0.
No, it's not necessary.
We don't need it. Take it away and never let it come back.
Yeah.
Because Age of Ultron is actually a good movie.
It is.
I'm not gonna play. It might be the second best Avengers movie.
Wow.
It might be, in my opinion.
That's a bold claim.
That's fine. Everyone thinks it's bottom. It's not. Alright? But Miss Minutes is not Ultron 2.0.
No, we don't need to see her really ever again.
No.
I think it would be good if they killed her off really, really quickly and just leave Renslayer to Renslayer things.
Mm-hmm.
I'll take that.
I'd like that.
I'll take that. But she is adding this element of destruction within the story. She's lying left, right, and center, supposedly.
Well, we don't know when she's lying and when she's not. And she's selling herself as kind of an omnipresent figure.
Yeah.
Right?
But there is this thing of we really can't trust what she's saying.
Mm.
Depending on who she's talking to, she could be lying at any point just so she can get herself more power and a physical form.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, one more thing you were saying as we were watching. We're coming back to this theory, this old theory, that Mobius is a Thor variant. And I cannot stand that now, the longer we're watching this, the more there is this sense of confirmation bias that I'm seeing maybe this absolute Muppet was correct.
The more words that get spoken, the more I'm really weaving together this story in my own head that no, I really do believe now Mobius is actually Thor. And he's just forgotten, he's lost his powers somehow, the TVA has zapped him of that. And I think partially to do with the Thor situation is when you look at Thor in Thor 1, he lost his powers because Odin took them from him. But if Thor forgot he was Thor, would he actually have that power or would he not?
That's a good question. And if he doesn't even know that Mjolnir exists, would he be able to call Mjolnir to him?
Exactly.
Maybe not. It was that scene specifically where they came to those statues of Odin and Thor and then Baldur.
Yeah.
And Loki was like, why is Baldur even here? You know, no one knows who he is.
Baldur exists in the main timeline. We've just never seen him.
Yeah.
Because he was supposed to be in Doctor Strange and the Multiverse of Madness as the main Asgardian in that offshoot world. But we've never seen him in the main continuity.
But for us watching that, it was a, wait a second. That Mobius thing he said, you know, it does baffle my mind, boggle my mind to think that
You're one of these guys.
And that can be taken two ways. It can be taken as, Loki, you're so different from this concept we have as Guardians. Not because you're a Jotun, but because of this humanity that you've gained in the way that you're working with me and working to help this greater picture. And also, it's like, we don't always see your powers, Loki, so I forget that you're this powerful. But it could also be like a, it's weird to think you're one of these guys. I'm one of these guys. I don't remember.
And then it comes down to the whole thing about fate and brotherhood and the elevator scenes and the fact that at the end of the day, the people saving the universe may just be Thor and Loki, just not the way you think.
The more I think about it, the more I like it. This idea that maybe He Who Remains saw this version of Mobius being Thor and saw this version of Loki and said, we put them together. This is actually destiny weaving them together because they will be the best team because Thor and Loki always make the best team. They are the guys who can get the job done. But if this is the case, then maybe.
It's Sylvie and Mobius.
Maybe, just maybe. In the Marvels, it's Mobius on the Bifrost.
Mobius on the Bifrost! Ooh! Depending on how this season ends, that's something right there.
What if it's actually
the confusion in theatre, because most people have not watched Loki, season one or two.
Yeah.
They will be baffled, like, what the hell is Owen Crooked Nose Wilson doing in my Marvel movie? And why is he dressed like Thor?
You know what, guys? I wouldn't put it past him.
That one seems like it would be unfathomable, but I am believing it more and more.
I know.
Mm-hmm.
I know. I love it when things like that happen. When we come up with things like that. Come up with the most wacky stuff and then we find a way to make it make sense.
Yeah.
Right? Which is the best type of storytelling. You find your endpoint and say, okay, how can I make this make sense?
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And that's the way that the cookie has to crumble sometimes. Right?
I like it. I like it a lot.
Episode 4 is next week. Please continue this trend of not being dog shit, and we will continue watching very happily. We'll continue reviewing very pleasantly, and hopefully, at the end of the day, the MCU will be saved. I don't know if that's gonna happen, but I really do hope it does. Anyway, guys, if you did enjoy this video, please do like, share, comment, and subscribe to the channel down there. If you didn't, Thor gonna come after you. You don't want that. No, do they want that?
No.
No, so just subscribe anyway to avoid that. I've been Narendra the comic.
I've been Nonsensei.
She's been Nonsensei. You have been Grant. We'll see you next time. That's tomorrow. If you don't know, make a video every single day. Been doing it every day for over 5 years now, and we are stopping till we get to 10,000 subscribers. So do subscribe. Pop back again tomorrow for some more quality shitty content. So hashtag never not hashtag goes. Also bring the pakwas. Pakwas means nonsense in Punjabi. We also bring that. Bring a lot. Bring a little. Do a lot. Do a little. But we're doing it. Bring the quality shitty content on a daily basis. So see you tomorrow for more of the same. Slightly different, but essentially the very same. Once more, see you then. Skadoosh.
You friggin' psycho! I got you!